Hello, this is Colin Goble. In this demonstration, we'll see how to open a file on disk. In this case, it's going to be this file, text.txt. I'll open it up for you, and you'll see it has three lines of text. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. There are three lines, and we're going to read this file twice. First time we're going to read the file, we'll print it out one, or we'll echo it to the console, to the screen, one line at a time. Then we'll rewind it to the beginning and echo the file one token at a time. So a token in this case is each word. Remember that in C++ a token ends with white space, where white space is one or more space characters, new line characters, or possibly tab characters. In this case there are no tabs, it's just spaces and new lines. Okay, I'll close this file. Let's open up Dev C++. Here's the program, and let's execute this program. So I will compile and run the program, and you'll see that the first time we read it, the file is opened and displayed one line at a time. We get to the end of file, and then we rewind the file and display it one token at a time. So let's take a look and see how this was done. In this program, once again, we're doing input-output to the console, so we need IOStream. We're going to be reading from the file system, so we need FStream. And we're going to be using C++ strings, so we need to include #include string. Nothing here has changed from the previous demo. We have some declarations of some variables that we're going to be using. Input file name is merely a string which contains the name of the input file we're going to open. Line is a string which is going to contain each line one at a time as we read the file. And token is another string which contains each token as we read the file one token at a time. As before, input file is an object of type ifstream. This is the stream we're going to connect to the file system with the open command and use that, and that's the stream we're going to read one at a time as we read tokens or lines respectively. Now initially in this particular demo, to keep life simple, I'm not prompting the user for the file name. I've commented the code that prompts the user out. I've hard coded the open here, input file.open. And there's the path, the full path to the name of, to the file that we want to read as our input file. Remember that a backslash inside a string in C++ has a special meaning. It's an escape character. So for example, backslash T is what you type in a string for the tab character. Backslash N inside a string maps onto the new line character. So because a backslash has a special meaning, if you actually want to put a backslash in a path name, you actually need to use a double backslash as I've done here. So this line of code opens up the file text.txt in this folder. It's hard-coded into the open statement. As before, we're going to open it. We're going to check if the file opens successfully. If it fails, we're going to display an error message. And then we're going to pause the output, and we're going to exit the program with an error code of 1. There's the error handler right there. Now, the next thing that we want to do in this program is read the file one line at a time. So, in this loop, we're going to ask if there's another line to be read. And one way to do that is to peek at the next item to be read out of the input file. If there's nothing further to be read, then the peek command will return a value of EOF, which is a C++ constant. Notice it's all in caps, meaning end of file. So what peek does is it lets you look at the next token or item in the input stream. If it's not equal to end of file, we're going to read the next line in the file. But if the next thing there is end of file, then of course there's nothing to read, and so our while loop needs to terminate. So the while statement here, we're going to take the input file stream, we're going to peek at the next character. It means we're going to look at it but not read it. That's what peek means, look at it but not read it, by which I mean look at it but don't remove it from the input file stream. And then we're going to loop all the time it's not equal to end of file. The exclamation point equals is C++'s way of saying not equals. In that case, I'm going to read a line from the input file. This is just like get line from cin, but I'm not reading from the console this time. I'm reading from my input file stream called input file, and I'm going to read it into the string variable declared earlier called line. Okay, having read it in, I'm going to echo the line out, so the string that I read in is in line. I'm going to output it to the standard output, cout less than line, outputs the line to standard output. And once the loop terminates, then the result of the peak is equal to EOF, the loop terminates, and the flow of control passes here, at which point we output end of file reached. Once again, notice the backslash n here is those two characters are known in C++ as a special escape sequence. They will insert a new line at the beginning of this message and an additional new line at the end of this message. So there's one new line there, and by the way, the ENDL also generates an additional new line character. So actually there'll be a blank line at the beginning and a blank line following end of file reached. Now it turns out that when you get to the end of file, various flags get set on the input stream to indicate that end of file is reached. And unless you explicitly clear those flags, you can't read anything further from that input stream. So when we get here, we have reached the end of file. It's really important to clear the end of file flag. By the way, clear also clears any error flags that may also have been set. Because if we don't clear those flags, even though we rewind the file back to the beginning, no further reading will be allowed because the system will still think that it's at end of file. So, mandatory, therefore, that we clear the end of file flag before we rewind. We'll then rewind to the beginning. Seek G stands for seek get. We won't go into too many details of why it's called that, but what this does is it rewinds the input file stream back to byte number 0 in the file, or the first character in the file, character number 0 in the file. Remember that in C++, any sequences always start numbering from 0, so character 0 in a file, or byte 0 in the file, you can think of as the first character in the file. Okay. Having rewound the file, we'll now read it again one token at a time. The greater than sign, as it did in the last example, will read the file. We'll extract one token from the file up as far as the next white space, and we'll read the file one token at a time. As before, this expression here returns false when we get to end of file. So this while loop terminates automatically after we've read the last token in the file. In that case, once again, the program outputs end of file reached. We close the input file. We've read it twice now. We close it, and then we put on the standard code to make sure that our output doesn't flash off the screen. Okay, so let's make a couple of changes here. Let's prompt the user for the file name. Let's read it into input file name. Let's open it here with this statement, the one we had before. Input file name, and we have to convert it to an old style C string. Let's not use this hard-coded file name. That was just there to show you how to do that if you wanted a hard-coded file name. And now let us recompile the program. Let's put in a file name. In this case it's text.txt. We have to type it in this time. We hit the enter key. Once again, it's processed and read out one line at a time. So this program demonstrates how to do that. Tells you it's reached end of file. The file is rewound to the beginning, byte number 0. It's then processed one token at a time. At the end of that, it says end of file reached. It's now paused on the screen, as always, waiting for the user to hit the enter key, stopping the output, scrolling off the screen. So I'll hit the enter key, the output goes away. And that concludes this demonstration of how to read a file line at a time, how to read a file a token at a time, and finally, how to read it twice and rewind the file between the two times that you read it. Thank you so much.